So, well, students, we continue questions based on differentiation of parametric equations. Already we have solved some more number of examples. We have still some more examples in this regard. So, right, next question. Find d2y by dx2. Find d2y by dx2 if x equals to a into bracket cos theta plus theta into sin theta, y equals to a into bracket sin theta minus theta into cos theta. So already we know how the procedure to be taken for these kind of problems. First, rewrite once again the given equations of x and y. Given x equals to a into bracket cos theta plus theta sin theta. Call it as equation 1. And also y equals to a into bracket sin theta minus theta cos theta, call it as equation 2. We shall differentiate 192 with respect to theta. Next up, differentiating 1 with respect to theta. Differentiation of x becomes dx by d theta, right hand side, a outside, whereas in the bracket we supposed to apply sum rule, whereas here we need to apply product rule. First, d by d theta cos theta plus d by d theta theta into sin theta. Further, a into bracket, differentiation of cos theta is minus of sin theta. Here by product rule, first function theta into differentiation of sin theta is cos theta plus second function sin theta into differentiation of theta is 1, that is neglected. Now in the process, minus sin theta plus sin theta will cancel out. So leaving out dx by d theta equals to a theta cos theta. Better highlight it. I mean underline it. Same manner, we shall differentiate 2 also with respect to variable theta. Differentiating 2 similarly with respect to theta. Left side dy by d theta, right side a into bracket. In the bracket sum rule, afterwards product rule. First differentiation of sin theta with respect to theta minus differentiation of theta cos theta. That is equals to a into bracket differentiation of sin theta is cos theta minus. Here by product rule, first function theta into differentiation of cos theta is minus sin theta, plus second function cos theta into differentiation of theta is 1. Further, a into bracket cos theta. Now this bracket is multiplied from minus, minus into minus plus theta sin theta, and minus into plus minus cos theta. does cos theta minus cos theta will cancel out. Hence, dy by d theta equals to a theta sine theta. Let's take formula for dy by dx in parametric form. In parametric form, dy by dx formula is dy by d theta divided by dx by d theta. Next, we know that dy by dx equals to dy by d theta whole divided by dx by d theta. Substituting values of dy by d theta and dx by d theta, what it becomes is that now a theta sine theta divided by a theta cos theta. So now a theta will cancel out. At the same time, sin theta by cos theta will be equals to tan theta. Hence, dy by dx equal to tan theta. Further, we are given to find the second derivative also. We now continue. Now d2y by dx2 equals to nothing but d by dx of dy by dx. That is d by dx of dy by dx value is tan theta. Further, differentiation of tan theta with respect to x will be secant square theta into d theta by dx. Now, d2y by dx2 equals to secant square theta multiplied by d theta by dx. That is secant square theta into d theta by dx can be written as 1 divided by dx by d theta. That's overall secant square theta divided by dx by d theta. So that now we can replace value of dx by d theta, which already we noted in the earlier steps. Secant square theta divided by dx by d theta value is formed as a theta into cos theta. That's the value for dx by d theta what we substituted out. Finally, 1 by cos theta will become secant square secant theta. Secant theta into secant square theta become secant cube theta. Final answer, secant cube theta divided by a theta. Next problem, in continuation. If x equals to e power t into bracket sin t minus cos t y equals to e power t into bracket sin t plus cos t find dy by dx. Find dy by dx at t equals to pi by 4. So write values of x and y once again given x equal to e power t into bracket sin t minus cos t curl 1. Also given y value, curl it as 2. Differentiating 192 with respect to variable t. Very first, differentiating 1 with respect to t. Dx by dt. We need to apply product rule. First function e raised to t into differentiation of sin t minus cos t. Plus second function sin t minus cos t into differentiation of e raised to t. Further, dx by dt equals to e power t into bracket differentiation of sin t cos t, differentiation of cos t minus sin t. So that minus of minus plus sin t minus cos t into differentiation of e raised to t is e raised to t. Now there can be a common factor e power t. On taking common e power t in the bracket, left is sin t plus sin t, 2 sin t, and actually cos t will cancel out. So total result 2 sin t after taking e power t common. Hence dx by dt defined by now 2 e power t into sin t. Similarly, we shall differentiate equation 2 also with respect to variable t, differentiating 2 with respect to t. Left side dy by dt, right side by product rule, first function e power t into differentiation of sin t plus cos t is cos t minus sin t. Plus second function sin t plus cos t into differentiation of e power t is e power t. Next there will be a common factor in right hand side, that is being e power t is common. After e power t common, left out cos t minus sin t plus sin t plus cos t. Sin t minus sin t will cancel out. Cos t plus cos t, 2 cos t. Hence the final simplified answer of dy by dt is 2 e power t into cos t. Now let's find out dy by dx by usual process of parametric functions. Now dy by dx equals to defined by dy by dt whole divided by dx by dt. dy by dt value is 2 e power t cos t divided by dx by dt value is 2 e power t sin theta. Hence now 2 e power t will cancel out. At the same time, cos t divided by sin t will be cot of t. Hence dy by dx equal to cot t. Further, we are given to find at t equal to pi by 4. Let's calculate. At t equals to pi by 4, dy by dx equals right hand side becomes cot pi by 4, but cot pi by 4 is known as 1. That's all. The same question may be given to find d2y by dx2 that we are given. Further, we have to continue. At that time, the answer is differentiation of cot t minus cos square t into dt by dx, or 1 divided by dx by dt. Substitute value of dx by dt, that is 2 e power t sin t, and simplify. That will be the value for d2y by dx2. Now let's have some additional problems before we end up the differentiation topic. Some additional problems. You can think as good as miscellaneous problems. Write to some additional problem. First problem in additional type. If x to the power of m into y to the power of n equal to x plus y to the power of m plus n. If x power m into y power n equal to x plus y power m plus n, understandably m and n non-zero real numbers, then show that. Then show that dy by dx equals to y by x. Next, hence show that. Hence means using dy by dx. Hence show that, or hence prove that. Hence show that d2y by dx2 equals to 0. Solution. We first write at again given implicit equation. Solution. Given that x power m into y power n equal to x plus y to the power of m plus n, curl equation 1. And if you want, you can directly differentiate here by product rule, here first by power rule, after that sum of function rule, then simplification, etc. That may be somewhat complicated, but we can make it very easier by taking logarithms. Let's take log on both sides so that our problem will become to a simplest format. So taking logarithms to equation 1. Applying logarithms to equation 1, understood that logarithm to the base e. Left side, log x to the power of m into y to the power of n equals to log of x plus y to the power of m plus n. let's apply logarithm theorem. It's just like log AB. Log AB is log A plus log B, means it is log x to the power of m plus log y to the power of n. Right hand side, it is just like log p to the power of q, whose formula is q into log p, means m plus n into log of x plus y. Since you write using the formula, what's formula? Log of pq equal to log p plus log q. Whereas log p to the power of q equals to q into log of p. Once again we use log theorem, namely log p to the power of q, q log p here becomes m log x sin n log y. M into log of x plus n into log of y equals to m plus n into log of x plus y. Now this equation, what we got, we shall differentiate with respect to x. Differentiating the equation what we got just now with respect to x. M into differentiation of log x is 1 by x, total m divided by x. Here differentiation of log y, 1 by y into dy by dx, that is total n by y into y dash or dy by dx. Right side, m plus n into bracket. Differentiation of log x plus y, 1 divided by x plus y, not only 1 by x plus y into differentiation of x, 1 plus differentiation of y will be y dash or divided by x. Now let us simplify to reach our asking answer. Next step, m divided by x plus n divided by y into y dash equals to, here bracket can be multiplied from this m plus n divided by x plus y. First term, m plus n divided by x plus y. Next term, m plus n divided by x plus y into y dash. Now let us collect y dash terms together. This y dash term we shall bring to left hand side. Non y dash term we shall shift to right hand side. So collecting y dash terms at one side, non y dash terms at other side. That means n by y dash minus m plus n by x plus y into y dash equals to m plus n by x plus y minus m divided by x. Now in the left hand side, common y dash, at the same time LCM also can be taken. So taking LCM at both sides, Left side LCM is y into x plus y. Right side LCM is x into x plus y. So very first y dash common, at the same time LCM is y into x plus y. That makes n into x plus y minus y into m plus n. Right hand side, LCM is x into x plus y. What it makes is that x into m plus n minus m into x plus y. Further, y dash into bracket, opening bracket nx plus ny minus my minus ny divided by y into x plus y equals to right hand side. Also opening brackets in numerator, mx plus nx
जयेश ग्रेट है वो
सर कैमरा चालू
है ले ले कुछ अगर नहीं आप पढ़े
कैमरा चालू है तो
नेक्स्ट माइनस एम एक्स माइनस एम वाई डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स इनटू एक्स प्लस वाई. Now on simplification, both sides x plus y will cancels. In left side, in the numerator ny cancels. In the right side, mx will cancel out. Hence now y dash into leftover is nx minus my divided by y equals to nx minus my divided by x. Further, this nx minus my by y becomes that side reciprocal, means y divided by nx minus my. Hence y dash equal to nx minus my divided by x into y divided by nx minus my. Obviously nx minus my will cancel out. Leftover is the required answer for divided by x. Hence y dash equals to y by x, or dy by dx equals to y by x. Let's find y double dash also. Now y double dash equals to, means dy by dx to equals to nothing but differentiation of y dash. It is dy dx of y dash. or y double dash equals to d by dx of y dash means y by x. Now to differentiate y by x, we need to apply quotient rule. Let's apply quotient rule. On applying quotient rule, denominator whole square, the denominator x into differentiation of y dash minus numerator y into differentiation of x is 1, left out. I ignore. Here we shall replace value of y dash. Replacing value of y dash, or replace y dash equal to y by x. Already we got that y dash as y by x, that value we shall replace here. Therefore, y double dash equals to x into y dash means y by x. There is already minus y, and all that is divided by x square. Xx will cancel out. Y double dash left over is y minus y divided by x square. Finally, y minus y, nothing but 0. So y double dash equal to 0. That's the required result. One more thing you keep in mind, whenever y dash is y by x, for any problem, if y dash is y by x, y double dash always becomes 0, in that no doubt at all. Next problem, under additional questions. If y equals to sine of m sine inverse x, understood that m is non-zero constant, then find the value of, then find the value of 1 minus x square into y2 minus x into y1. Or it may be given, show that 1 minus x square into y2 minus x y1 equal to minus of m square y. I just given as to find. So let's find this quantity value, given that y equal to sine of m sine inverse of x. Solution. Given, what is given? Given that y equal to sine of m sine inverse of x, curl 1. Differentiating 1 with respect to x. On differentiating 1 with respect to x, left side y1, right side d by dx of sine of m sine inverse of x. Further, y1 equals to, it's a composite function, first coming function is sine, sine function differentiation is cos, means cos of m sine inverse x. Not enough, multiplied by differentiation of m sine inverse x. Further, y1 equals to cos of m sine inverse x multiplied by differentiation of m sine inverse x, m outside, into differentiation of sine inverse x is 1 by square root of 1 minus x square. Next, root of 1 minus x square can be cross multiplied on cross multiplying square root of 1 minus x square. What it becomes is that root of 1 minus x square into y1 equals to m into cos of m sin of x. If you want, you can square on both sides, or if you want, you can now only differentiate. Choice is yours. So what I'm telling is that you can square, then differentiate, or you can differentiate now only. Does not make any difference for the required answer. Now differentiating with respect to x second time. In the left side, we need to apply product rule. First function, root of 1 minus x square into d by dx of y1 plus second function y1 into d by dx of root of 1 minus x square. Right hand side, m into differentiation of cos of m sin of x. Minus x square into differentiation of y1 is defined as y2 plus y1 into differentiation of square root function is 1 divided by 2 into square root 1 by 2 root of 1 minus x square into differentiation of x square is 2x along with minus sign m into differentiation of cos function is minus of sine function means minus of sine of m sine inverse x. That's not enough. Into derivative of m sine inverse x. Further, here 2 will cancel out. The left is root of 1 minus x square into y2 minus x into y1 divided by root of 1 minus x square. That is equal to right hand side minus m into sine of sine of x. Multiplied by differentiation of m sin of x means m outside into 1 by root of 1 minus x square, total m by root of 1 minus x square. Observe the given equation 1. From equation 1, sin of m sin of x can be replaced by y. So all this is equals to y. At the same time, m into m become m square. Further, root of 1 minus x square into y2 minus x into y1 divided by square root of 1 minus x square equals to right hand side m into m, m square. At the same time, sine of m sine of x will be y. So totally it is minus m square of y by square root of 1 minus x square. lastly, we shall multiply by root of 1 minus x square on both sides. Finally, multiplying by square root of 1 minus x square. So with multiplying by root of 1 minus x square, what we get is that now finally. Here, root of 1 minus x square into root of 1 minus x square will become root of 1 minus x square whole square into y2. Whereas in next term, root of 1 minus x square when it is multiplied, they will get cancelled out because of multiplication and division minus xy1. In the right hand side also, square root of 1 minus x square will cancel out, leaving out minus m square y. Now lastly here, square and square root will cancel out, hence left over 1 minus x square into y2 minus x into y1 equals to minus of m square y. Or it may be taken as plus m square y equals to 0. So further examples we take up in the next class. Thank you very much.